Investor visa elements. Funds must be irrevocably committed. What does that mean? That seems like such an ambiguous phrase in the law, and of course that's not the first and it will not be the last. But the way to think of an investment that's irrevocably committed is not, it's not pie in the sky, it's not something that has the potential. It's something that you have taken action and steps towards it. It's things like you have started a company, or it's things like you have entered into an agreement that has a conditional clause that upon approval of the visa, you will purchase that apartment complex, or you will purchase that trucking company, or that car wash, or what have you. And so irrevocably committed, one way to irrevocably commit your funds is also to put them in escrow. And so the funds are really, they've been sent, so they're ready. And so all that really needs to take place is actually getting your visa. And many times, I mean, we work with a lot of clients that they actually went and purchased the business independently of whether they will get the visa or not. And so I know sometimes that's a little scary, but when you put your funds and when you put your money and your equity in a stage that is gone, it's committed, it's done. Your odds of success for your visa are a lot better, because the official is saying, they're not just trying to get a United States benefit. They're not trying to get a visa to come to the United States. They are really committed to this, you know, and this is not a pipe dream. This is not, something that they've done nothing about. This is not just on paper, but this is actually in the world. And so that's the general definition of funds being irrevocably committed, and some of the different ways that you can make that happen. Thank you for watching.